food. You know, I just couldn't stop thinking about it.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I went to the fridge, and I opened up the meat drawer. You know what the meat drawer is, right?
Yeah. What was in there?
Well, I'll tell you what was in there. You know that bacon that's like maple? It's got maple flavor.
The maple kind, yeah.
Yeah, so...
Yeah.
I took that out, and I thought...
Yeah.
I know who would like that. Me! So I ate it.
Oh! No. You're kidding me.
Nope. Not kidding. You know, I also noticed there was some beef in there. Yeah, you know, steak, you know, juicy. Well, I ate that too. But I went back in the fridge just a few minutes ago, and I put something together really special. You're going to love this one. I took some chicken.
Yeah.
I put some, yeah, I put some cheese on it. And I covered it with...
Covered it with what?
I covered it with cat treats.
Yeah.
Then guess what?
What?
I gave it to the cat.
Morning, class. My name is Matthew Shin, and this is a speech about who I am. As you can tell, I am a dog lover. There are many things that describe people, what we love, what we do, what our hobbies are, what we eat. That there's certain qualities about each of us that describe who we are. For me, that's a dog. I can't get enough of them. For me, one of my strengths was empathy. And that means putting yourself in other people's shoes and knowing where they come from and adjusting to their pain in that aspect. I don't know if you've ever had a dog. I have, and anytime I've been sad, sick, anyone around my dogs have been sad or sick, they lay right next to them, lick their face. They feel the pain from a human and try to react to it. And that's empathy in its greatest performance to me. Today I'm going to go over what I've learned in this class and my future applications of what I've learned. So, in this class I've learned how to build and prepare noteworthy professional speeches. I've gone from talking about myself once before to introducing y'all to the great Jim Carrey, favorite actor, learning how to play the guitar, and persuading y'all against the falsehoods about global warming. Each speech has within itself carried the strength, weakness of each I've duly noted and continue to grow upon. I can't find a speech out of those that I've cared about more because they all have positive and negative things about them. I've learned to present myself in a more credible manner. Because without presenting yourself in a credible manner, no one will take you seriously. They won't take you to that extra edge. Take, for instance, how much more important is it going to be if it actually rains outside for me to be a meteorologist? I can count on one hand, more than one hand, how many bad meteorologists in the past have people blamed when they got their jackets on, their raincoats on, they go outside and it's 70 degrees and it's good weather to go play some football, and they get angry. Well, that kind of goes back to the guy's credibility and knowing what he's saying on the TV to really enforce what is going to happen. So I've learned a lot about presenting myself in a more credible manner, more professional, so people can listen to it more business-like, trustworthy manner. My future applications of what I've learned, I hope to apply these methods to the future, giving a forecast, for example, job interviews, or even going back to Aggieland, my home, away from home, to train new freshmen in the Corps of Cadets. A lot of you might know what the Corps of Cadets is. A lot of you might have heard of it. It's a training program for young men and women to develop character and learn how to be a leader, to prepare themselves for a life in the military or a life in the business world if you just want that extra help. What's so special about it is that you can teach and coach and train on your style. And from this class, giving speeches and having to do research and having to build organizational patterns the way we've been taught has not only helped me give a speech properly, it's something I can carry with me to train someone in a more credible fashion that will help them learn more, I can train them better, and they can like me more as a mentor to them. I plan to apply my top five strengths to all aspects of my life. My top five strengths are including empathy, harmonious, includer, developer, communications. All five of those speak to me in the form of the dog as well. Very very empathetic, very harmonious. If a dog is in a household that is unease, she'll let you know. They include everybody. The dogs love everyone for the most part. Developer, they'll be there to keep you up here when you're down. And they'll communicate to you whether you go to the bathroom, that they're hungry, etc. Today I've gone over what I've learned and future applications of what I've learned. I'm going to leave you with this closing thought. From Master at Alana, you are your own judge. The verdict is up to you. Thank you for your time.